Now, tonight and this morning, Vermont Senator Bernie Sanders and New Jersey Senator Cory Booker joined delegates from five Midwestern states to kick off the day, day three of the Democratic National Convention. Our Ryan Jenkins gives us a look now and an update on what was said at the virtual breakfast.
Two former presidential hopefuls now encouraging political organizers and delegates to get out and mobilize their communities to vote for Democratic presidential nominee Joe Biden.
We still are a nation where the power of the people is greater than the people in power.
Senator Cory Booker sharing a story about his own childhood when volunteers helped his family fight systemic racism in the 1960s.
I'm sitting here today because years before I was born, there was a white man on a couch who, when his country was in a moral moment, he didn't allow his inability to do everything to undermine his determination to do something for the cause of his country.
Booker's story aimed to encourage delegates from Wisconsin, Michigan, Minnesota, and North and South Dakota to mobilize within their neighborhoods and ignite a passion for campaign organizing ahead of the 2020 election.
We are in that moral moment again, and all of us, the activists on this call, we now have to ignite the urgency in others who are sitting on the sidelines.
Senator Bernie Sanders telling Democrats it's time to do everything possible to ensure Biden's success over President Trump.
It is absolutely imperative that all of us work together, reach out to our friends, our neighbors, coworkers, and defeat Trump.
Sanders says Democrats must also focus on the push for policies surrounding income inequalities, racial and criminal justice, and climate change.
The day after the election, we have got to rally the American people to create an agenda that works for all and not just large corporations and the 1%.
Wisconsin Congressman Mark Pocan also spoke this morning. He was the only Wisconsin lawmaker to speak at today's virtual breakfast. He encouraged people to get out and vote early to avoid any potential issues, submitting absentee ballots if necessary this election. Reporting in Milwaukee, Ryan Jenkins, TMJ4 News.